everybody, and welcome to the podcast, Coffee with the Kensington, where each month we discuss all things related to seniors, their families, and caregivers. My name is Brenda Moynihan, and I am the Director of Marketing Outreach at the Kensington Assisted Living Residence in White Plains. Today, my guest is Patty Cervais, VA accredited agent and founder of Elder Resource Benefits Consulting. And today we're going to talk about the VA benefit aid and attendance. Welcome, Patty.
Thank you, Brenda. It's nice to be here.
Sure. So Patty, let's get right into it. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the company, Elder Resource Benefits Consulting, and how you got there?
Well, how I got there was I was a CPA. I was working at Pricewaterhouse, the Boston Globe, doing mergers and acquisitions. And eventually I wanted to do something where my CPA could be of a benefit to seniors. And I came across somebody who was having a difficult time getting the VA pension with aid and attendance. And somebody had told them that I could figure it out for them. I had never heard of it before. This person would not leave my office. And I said, okay, I'll take a look. And I was hooked. I got her the benefit in about 6 weeks, and that's all she wrote. I've been doing it ever since.
Good for you. So, Patty, let's tell our audience, let's get into it, because many people don't even know anything about this benefit for veterans. So why don't you tell the audience exactly what it is?
Okay. Well, first of all, nobody should feel bad if they haven't heard about the VA pension. The General Accounting Office came out with their numbers on this program, and they said less than 11% of the wartime veterans who should be getting this benefit are receiving it. And it's less than 8% for surviving spouses. So basically what this is, it's called VA pension with aid and attendance. It's not a military pension. It's a VA pension, and it's for our wartime veterans or their surviving spouses. So if you've served at least 90 days on active duty, have served in at least one day during a period of war, and then other than dishonorably discharged, you very well might meet the military requirement. There's no need to have served overseas or married. The surviving spouses have to have been married to a veteran who met that criteria at the time of his death. Now, the 90-day criteria of service, of total active service, does go up to 2 years for our Gulf War veterans, but prior to the Gulf War, it's only a 90-day requirement. Okay. And it's a lot of money that they can get under this program.
And you're talking about World War II veterans, Vietnam vets, right? You're including all of them in that group.
Exactly. And the big thing when you're talking about World War II, Korea, Vietnam veterans, and our Gulf War veterans is do not get fooled by the History Channel or by the know-it-all neighbor next door. The dates of war for this benefit are set by Congress. So it doesn't matter what the History Channel says.
Okay, good. That's a good point.
Yeah.
And let's talk about that chunk of money that is available, right, through the government for these veterans if they qualify. What kind of money? What are we talking about?
So number one, the money is tax-free. And for our surviving spouses, they can get up to $1,318 per month. A single veteran can get up to $2,050 per month. And a married veteran who he's still healthy, but his wife is ill, maybe living in an assisted living community or an independent living community, they can get up to $1,608 per month. And a married veteran where the veteran himself has need for home care or independent living, assisted living, can get up to $2,431 a month.
You know, I want to interject because I am from the Kensington, I work at the Kensington, we are a senior living, and I think that's important for people to understand. Even if your loved one lives in an assisted living, they could still, if they qualify, they could still get this money, they could still get this benefit, correct?
That's correct. Yeah.
Yeah. That's important.
That's important. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So apart from the 90 days serving and all of that, what are the financial, because I'm sure there's parameters in reference to money. You know, if you're a millionaire, you're not getting this benefit. So what are those parameters?
So you have to have less than $138,489 in assets, excluding your primary home. Your home does not count against you, even if you're no longer living in it and you've moved into a community. Your home does not count against you. So we have folks all the time who their home might be worth, you know, $200,000, $300,000, $800,000, $1 million. It does not count. What counts? Cash, stocks, bonds, securities. If your home is on more than 2 acres and can be subdivided, then we're going to have to assign a value to the acreage over 2 acres. Rental properties count. If you own a rental property with family members and the other family members aren't willing to sell, we can sometimes get the rental property not to count. So basically, cash, stocks, bonds, securities, IRAs, 401ks, cash surrender values of annuities, those are going to count. And if they're less than $138,489, you pass the asset test. Now, the income test is super important and the area where people make the most amount of mistakes. So the VA says your income has to be less than the benefit you're going for. Well, okay, for a surviving spouse, that's a $1,318. That's not very much. However, the definition of income for VA purposes is a math test. It's income as we all think of it, pension, Social Security, distributions from IRAs, minus what they might be paying to a place like the Kensington, minus what you're paying in home care, minus what you're paying for medical insurance premiums, anything that's considered a regularly occurring unreimbursed medical expense. So for example, if you had income of $3,000 a month, you might call the VA and say, hey, I'm looking at this pension and my income's $3,000 a month. What do you think? And they'll say, well, $3,000 a month, you're a veteran. The benefits, $2,050, you're over asset, over income, right, by $950. But it's a math test. So if you call and you say my income's $3,000 a month, but I'm paying an assisted living $3,500 a month, now your income for VA purposes is negative $500 and you pass with an entire full VA benefit, meaning even though you're only negative $500, they're going to give you the full $2,050 to help offset your costs if you're a veteran.
Right, because those fees that you're talking about, the medical, living in an assisted living, is deducted. So they don't count towards the income. That's what you're saying, correct?
They reduce income, yeah. Right. So if you have $3,000 in income, but you're paying $3,000 to an assisted living, let's say, you're paying $3,000 to assisted living, then your income for VA purposes, they call it IVAP, income VA purposes, is zero. And you pass the income test. Mm-hmm. Now you can have positive income.
Right.
So for,
right,
let's say we have a veteran who has $5,000 a month in income, and he's lucky enough to only be paying $4,000 to his assisted living and medical insurance premiums, et cetera. He'd be left positive $1,000. But it's still less than $2,050, which is the pension amount. So the VA would minus the $1,000 that he's positive from the $2,050 and give him the remainder.
And also, he qualifies, right?
Yeah. And also give him the opportunity, if his assisted living fee goes up or his medical insurance premiums go up, or he has out-of-pocket costs like new eyeglasses, to claim any increase in medical expenses that he might have.
Okay.
It's really wonderful.
So this wonderful VA benefit, mm-hmm, you're saying such a small percentage of people even know about it. And, you know, the surviving spouse, as you, I think you said 8% are even a part of this. How does someone go about, because this is a daunting task. I'm assuming you're going to have to collect all kinds of information, discharge papers. What does a family member, what does the person do? How do they get started?
Well, we think where you should start is by scheduling a call with Elder Resource Benefits Consulting. The reason we say that is, yes, in the end, you're going to need the discharge paper, but the way the VA benefit works, the money starts accumulating the first of the month after we notify the VA that you're going to be filing. So if I had somebody call me today and they're like, look, I don't have my discharge papers, but they knew how much their dad had in monthly income, what he was paying to his assisted living, what he estimated he was going to be paying to his assisted living if he hadn't moved in yet, and an understanding of their assets, and we thought it looked good, we would say, you know what, let's go ahead and lock you in. If when you get the discharge paper, it turns out he didn't serve during a period of war, no harm, no foul. Nobody's going to send you a mean letter. We just let the benefit, the application die. However, if you spend 6 months waiting to get that discharge paper from National Archives, which is about what they're taking right now,
right,
that's $12,000 gone forever.
Right.
Better
right.
to have that $2,000 a month accumulating while you wait to get the discharge. So we like to say a month's delay is a month's lost pay. Call us with your income numbers, your asset numbers, and you know we can start you down the path. And let's say you're over asset. Let's say you've got $200,000 in assets. Your phone call to us is free. We'll go through all your numbers and we'll say, based on what you've told us and the run rate that you have, the amount you're going to be negative each month, we think you're going to qualify in August. If you reach $138,489 in assets, call immediately. But regardless, call us in July so that we can, you know, kind of fine tune in when you're going to be able to get the benefit, because we don't want you to miss out on 1 month of this benefit that you're supposed to be getting.
I think it's important for the audience to understand, as you just said, you know, we've all heard the delays with the post office and everything like that. And if you apply, and as you said, if it takes 6 months to get that paperwork, guess what? At least you've got the information. They have it that you've applied, and it will be retroactive, correct? Back that 6 months, as long as you're accepted. But do it so that waiting for that information, you know, at least it's on the books that you've started that process, right?
Exactly. That's right. Yep. And then once we submit the application, we're seeing an average time to award of 3 months. So the VA is doing a very good job once we get them the information of turning it around. So that's nice. We see it taking people longer to pull together the data than it's taking the VA to decide the case.
Wow. Okay. So there's an income and asset qualification. There's you must serve and all those qualifications with that. What do you have to be able to show in order to get this benefit? In other words, there's got to be, you need assistance somehow. Is that correct?
That's right.
And what are the parameters of that?
Okay, so what the VA says is that you have to need custodial care, which is such a bad word for people in the senior living arena, because we think of custodial care as nursing home care, but the VA is allowed to come up with their own definitions, right? Just like they're allowed to call this thing a pension, right? They're allowed to come up with their own definitions, and they came up with custodial care. And what that means is that your doctor would say, you know what, you're not really safe to be living at home alone anymore. You should really be living in a community that's going to be providing you some supervision. So let's say that you're looking to move into independent living. Maybe what happened is you are not able to manage your food appropriately and you were failure to thrive. We had somebody who moved into a community whose son had gone over for lunch and his dad served him a rancid ham sandwich on green moldy bread. Mm-hmm. Now that he's living in independent living, that's not going to happen. So this man was very set on saying, my dad's fine. And I'm like, okay, why did he move in? Rancid ham sandwich story. Right, okay, right. Not fine. So I like to say what works with the VA is the truth. You just have to be able to get it onto the paper in a way that the VA is going to accept it. Because Brenda, they don't accept meal preparation, right? It just can't be meal preparation. It has to
be. There's got to be a reason behind. Right.
Exactly. This guy is going to get very sick. This guy might starve to death, right? Meal prep. So we really rely on the doctors, and the diagnosis has to support it. A lot of times we have folks who are like, well, my mom's just lonely. Okay. Is she really lonely, or are we talking depression here? Because depression and what an independent or assisted living can offer to get you engaged with other people and out of that depression is enough to be able to say you need supervision and therefore be able to get the benefit. But if it's really just that you're, you know, social butterfly and you want to be there bit popping out to your three bridge groups, you know, driving along in your car, then no, it's not for you yet.
Well, we've got about a minute left. Patty, I'd like you to tell the audience, because I'm sure people are very interested. They want to learn more. How can they get in touch with you to see if they even qualify?
Okay. Well, if you want to schedule a call with us on our website, it's www.elderbenefitsconsulting.com, or you can call us at 508-485-0039, and somebody will assist you in making the call. And everybody's first phone call is free. We're going to walk through your specific situation and tell you what we think about your ability to qualify for the VA benefit, and really stress it's not a yes or no benefit. It's if and when. And the earlier you call, the more prepared you're going to be to file when that when happens.
Great. Great. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining me today. And thank you, folks. And Patty, just repeat that phone number again, folks. Please give Patty a call if you're interested. You never know.
508-485-0039.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you, Brenda.
Have a great day, everybody.